Hello all. What I can I will tell you is how to use VLab and submit the assignments related to virtual labs. So for that, you need to search about VLab COEP. Once you'll search, you'll get this particular link. On that link, there's a register. So click on register. Enter the name. I am giving a name as Ravikant and Kamitkar Subhash. Date of birth, put it up as 1. Then mobile number. Here you need to choose NC, that is nodal center 53. So 53 is ours. That is you need to just scroll down, and if you see that it's NC 53 is NB Navle, Siangad College of Engineering, Solapur. So select that. So enter your email ID. For time being, I am using a different email ID created for this particular video. So click on I agree and click register. Once you'll register this, you will receive a confirmation email. You need to log into your Gmail account. So open a Gmail in the other account, so I am logging in with the Gmail. You will receive the email because you haven't inserted any password, right? Now, if you see, the email has been received by the user. So if we click on that, you will receive the details. So this is the password that you have to copy and your email ID. So you need to jump back to this particular login page, nn.student1@gmail.com, and click on sign in. So once you sign in for very first time, you can see all the departments, different departments, computer engineering, electronics and communication. In that, particularly electronics and communication, for VLSI design subject, what you need to do is you need to click on hybrid electronics lab. In that particular lab, what you need to perform is these two. So design and simulation of decoder, encoder, multiplexer. This is one, experiment one, and design and simulation of various counters and shift register. These two experiments you need to perform. So you can click on this. After clicking on this, you will see there is an aim given, what are the prerequisite objectives. So click on theory part. You will get a theory of decoders, encoders, everyone. So after that, the procedure, what is to be performed up, and then the lab manual being given, then the simulation. Now if you click on this, click here, the new window will pop up. So click OK on that. So if you see, this is the encoder circuitry. These are the buttons. So this is the decoder and this is the multiplexer. Now if you see that, it's a 8S2 1 MUX. So these are three select lines, S0, S1, S2. This is the D0, D1, D2, D3, D7 input, and this is Q output. Now if I select one and one, then this particular D7 will be taken to the output. So if I run this, as D7 is zero, the output will be zero. Now if I stop this running by clearing up and selecting this 1, 1, 1, and if I make this particular d7 also as a 1. If I run this, now you can see that the output has become 1. Now this is the working of multiplexer. Once you finish up with this performance, you need to take the print screenshot of it. Now taken that screenshot, open a Word file. In that Word file, put up as this screenshot, then name it as virtual experiment number 1, then write conclusion. So whatever conclusion you have got out of it after performing this particular experiment, and at the top you can write your roll number. So that roll number I am writing right now is 100. So save this file. So I will save this file on the desktop. I will name it as roll number 100. Okay. So once you save this, you need to go back and open up your Google Classroom. So in Google Classroom, this particular virtual lab has been assigned to you. So in that virtual lab, you need to choose virtual lab 1 submission and virtual lab 2 submission. For time being, I'm choosing virtual lab 2 submission, even though we have given the name as virtual lab 1. So in that submission, you need to click on add or create. So click on file. In the file, you need to select the file from the desktop. That the name of the file is roll number 100. So upload it. Upload that file. Once this particular file is uploaded, click on hand in. Until and unless you click on hand in, this particular virtual lab submission is not considered. So you need to finish up with this. So once you finish up for both the labs, you're done. So go back here. So this is what you have to do. Conclusion. So what are the results and the things? You need to put up a feedback. So click here. Select whatever you have failed, answer the questions accordingly, and click on submit. So you need to submit your feedback so that we can come to know that you have attempted this particular lab, and if there are some downloads that you can use for running this particular experiment, you can use it. Otherwise else, not necessary. Now if I go back here on the lab, so there are different subjects and topics that you can use for other subjects. As in instructed by your subject teachers, you can use that labs. For VLSI design subject, you need to go to hybrid electronics lab. Complete this design and simulation of decoders, encoders, multiplexer and demultiplexer, and design and simulation of various counters and shift registers. These two labs you need to finish up. So apart from that, you can choose different like computer engineering or electronics communication engineering, electrical engineering labs, and you can search and you can run different labs virtually. So this is a very good platform. There is one difficulty majorly people face is, I will show you that. So if I take the digital electronic circuit lab, and if I go with this particular lab, in that if I directly jump to the simulator and if I click on this, now the if we go to this particular simulator, you can see that the Adobe Flash Player is blocked or not available. So this is a major problem when you use Google Chrome. This is the problem. So if you take this URL, copy it, and use the Firefox browser, and in that Firefox browser, if you paste that link, you, as Firefox supports the Adobe Flash Player, so you can see that if I run this now, this particular experiment is running on this. So it is a workaround to avoid the problem of Adobe Flash Player not available in this. My kind suggestion to all the people who will be using mobile devices, even this works on mobile devices, but it's a bit difficult to work out using mobile devices. So it's always better try to work out it with the either desktop or a laptop. If it is not possible at all, go with the mobile. It works on the mobile also, but it is a bit difficult. That's my suggestion. So thank you so much. Hope you will finish the task as the earliest. So have a nice time ahead. Thank you.